Nestled amidst the lush green mountains of the Eastern Ghats lies Sundargarh. Yes, Sundargarh. Basking in the golden sunlight of tropical sun, Sundargarh brings to one's mind peace, comfort, and reassurance of a resurgent tomorrow. Nature has been very kind to Sundargarh. An abundance of bounties of nature soothing the nerves of the most tired of visitors. Sundargarh, a typical district of peace-loving Orissa. Kalinga, as it was known earlier, has hardly seen any turbulence since the famous Kalinga War. Its people are simple, their habits uncomplicated, and their needs simply the bare minimum. Engaged in their day-to-day activities, the people of Sundargarh make very little demands from the world around them. However, these deceptively simple folk are today engaged in a revolution of gigantic proportions. Now, after centuries of darkness and ignorance, they have plunged headlong into a major movement. The brief for the movement is simple. We have to change our lives. We have to be educated. And yes, they are into it. With frenzy and enthusiasm bordering on madness. Now they have a chance. They're not going to miss it. No, not going to miss it for anything in the world. When the sun rises over the blue mountains, the daily grind continues like an ongoing process. But life has to go on. But now, everyone has something to look forward to, something to hope for, something to achieve. Here, meet this gentleman, Mr. Agadhu Naik. He loves what he does. Well, he's been making pots ever since he knew he could turn the wheel. His fingers are perfectly aligned on the delicate clay. On his own turf, he's tough. He's confident. Why is he blushing? So, sir, you have been studying. And that too in the evenings after work. That's great, Agadhu. You can write your own name. Is it? That's fantastic. Thank you. People like Agadhu are becoming a familiar feature on the rural landscape of Sundargarh. Meet Kamal Devi. Don't be misled by her looks. Pretty fast at her studies. And yes, she started talking like a smart lady. When we asked her why she's studying, she did not mince words when she said, "Well, I'm studying for my own good." And much to the delight of workers and volunteers, the collector of Sundargarh, Mrs. Anita Agnihotri, turned out to be a boon in disguise. Her enthusiasm, her spirit of cooperation, and her steadfastness in removing illiteracy from her district became a matter of great encouragement for everyone connected with the project. She was often heard to say in confidence that we will succeed in what we have set out to achieve simply because we are true to ourselves and true to our goal, that of achieving total literacy in the district. Looking back on the tremendous strides that the Total Literacy Campaign has taken in Sundargarh district, it is impossible to believe that the same could have been possible without Mrs. Agnihotri's help. The potterer's wheel has now turned a full circle. His quest for education has rubbed onto his own family. Yes, she is Shanti, and she is only in the 9th standard. But then, age and educational barriers crumble in the face of dedication. In her spare time, she teaches ladies in her locality. And what does she get out of it? Well, she told us something amazing. She gets peace of mind. And do the elderly women mind such a young lady teaching them? By the looks of it, it doesn't seem so. Well, they all seem pretty happy with it. Well, all this has been because of the sustained efforts of Total Literacy Campaign, unleashed by National Literacy Mission. We talked to the district magistrate Sundargarh, who looks after the overall campaign in Sundargarh district.
April 1st, 1991, we started the Akshar Dan Divas. And since then, we have been in the program implementation. But we have a setback in the middle due to these elections for about 2 to 3 months. Then it actually started from the month of June and July, and it has set on thereafter. In Sundargarh district, we have got 2 separate programs, one for the Rourkela city and the other for the entire Sundargarh district. And for Rourkela city, we have got to make about 1 lakh of people literate. And in Sundargarh district, we have to make 3.5 lakh people literate. In Sundargarh district, we have to open about 34,000 centers. And we have by now opened more than 24,000 centers, which will be above 75%. And we have set the target date to December 31st, 1991 for declaring it as total literate. We have had a tremendous response from the people, from the voluntary organizations, because from the beginning, we have not paid a single farthing to the people for taking up this literacy work, except purchasing of books. At the initial stage, the people wanted this kerosene oil, but we could not give them due to want of money. But in spite of all these odds, in the remotest corner of the villages, in the tribal and Adivasi areas, they all were very much enthusiastic in making this program a success. You will find, when you go to the villages, that there is so much tremendous enthusiasm that once you go to a particular village and see one center, the people will not leave you unless you see all the 29 or 30 or 40 centers which are running there. And these teenagers, these girls, these boys, school teachers, volunteers, they are all engaged in this program, and they have been made so much of aware and motivated that they want to see the end of it. And we are sure that within the stipulated period, we will declare this district totally literate. And I hope that by the end of March 1992, whatever the leftouts will be there, those leftouts will be again covered, and in March 1992, the remnants will also be declared totally literate.
Literacy campaign now moves on to Rourkela, the steel city, the city that has changed the socio-political structure of the entire Sundargarh district. Rourkela, the city of dreams, for hundreds of innocent villagers spread in and around the steel city. Rourkela is the symbol of their future. The setting sun brings in a new hope, brings in an irresistible force into play, the force to be shaken free of the burden of illiteracy. Deceptively calm roofs of the rows and rows of unnumbered houses, there is a lot of activity, lot of enthusiasm, lot of drive. The total literacy mission in action. Everyone is wholly enthused by the tremendous response. Well, that's our Honorable Minister of Education, Odisha, giving us a helping hand. Thank you. She is Sukanti, a very dedicated volunteer. She is concerned that unavailability of kerosene as an incentive could put a damper on the activities. The ADM is right there on the scene. He orders redressal. The TLC spares no means to bring into its fold more and more people. Almost anything is employed. The man just asked if he will get free food if he goes to study. The volunteer very gently drove home the point. Once he was educated, he could forever be free from wants, free from hunger, free from exploitation. It's only when one doesn't study, problems crop up. Dayanand Das's association with the Shramik Vidyapeeth of Rourkela has been a long one, and the Shramik Vidyapeeth's contribution to the cause of adult education has been phenomenal. Starting out with the initial stages of this campaign in sorting out the modalities, the Vidyapeeth under Das's leadership has been helping spread the message of literacy. When the campaign was launched, there was much skepticism amongst the various officials and locals of the region. It was Dayanand Babu who took on the onus of responsibility of the project on himself. He single-handedly went about explaining the relevance of the project and the various advantages that the total literacy campaign could contribute to the lives of the people in improving the quality of their lives and making them face the various demands that today's modern society requires. Being a distinguished social worker himself, Mr. Das set an ideal example of himself to the people around him. And because of his demeanor, he endeared himself to the elders of the society, who became willing to listen to him and take his advice seriously. The total literacy campaign in Sundargarh owes a great deal to the efforts of Dayanand Babu.
Didi, tor kasa mor mudi me tor haat rai ki mai kaha to mai haadi daru aur jammai ni pimu mai.
Ho ho ho. Au kebe pibu ni bujhilu e chua.
It takes a little bit of explaining from the volunteer to make both husband and wife understand each other. Well, so much for the power of education.
Sesra kona bhikko magibe se mane e bhoni taku aau ki nai tumhe jacha ta kotha kahibo ni.
Well, it is necessary to involve everyone concerned in the city to achieve this goal. It is a campaign because we want to achieve a street-level consensus in this city from all the sections of society that it is necessary to achieve total literacy. It is desirable. It is an urgent necessity. For that, we are trying to heat up the atmosphere to a very surcharged and hot level where people come and participate in this campaign. We do a lot of street-level activities. We all sing and dance in the street, go together. This builds a very informal and a very campaign sort of an atmosphere. That is why we call it a campaign. It is difficult for several reasons. The most important reason is that in a city there is a lot of anonymity between neighbors, amongst people. There is no uniformity of profession that the people do. Then people are not available at a uniform time. The access to people is difficult because there is no common leadership. People are not familiar with each other. In a village, on the contrary, if you can communicate with the leader, the village elder, then it's very easy to have access to the villages. But in a city, it's very difficult to find any commonality between, amongst people.
When you have raw materials, when you have intelligent people, when we have hard-working people, when really they are given the charge, why then this will not happen? Why then we cannot be another Japan? That conviction was there among many of us. And finally, when we were given the training by persons who are really experts in this, we became really resource person for Rourkela. Rourkela is very fortunate to get people like us who have been drawn from educational institutions, from other like Rotary, Lion, and other voluntary organization.
उड़िया के साथ साथ हिंदी भाषा भाषी भी बहुत से लोग हैं, इसलिए